So one thing I like to do first is try not to spill any of the fuel, tip them upside down. I like to pull the bowls off of them just so I can see what exactly was in the fuel bowl, whether it was water or a bunch of dirt or exactly what. So
probably can't see this.
Well, that's adjust. These screws are generally Phillips head, but on the real older motors, like this one, they're square hex head and have a slotted screwdriver head. And of course this isn't easy without spilling it, but nice to find the damning evidence you're looking for. If you do have a problem, you'll know if you've been getting water through to the carbs or just what. So, let's see what we got to see in this fuel bowl. Trying to light it up here so you can see. So this one, as you can see, it's kind of cloudy, so there probably was, well, there probably wasn't any water in it anymore. It's been sitting so long, I'm sure it's all evaporated, but there is some serious debris and gunk in there. So let's pour that fuel out and see what's remaining. So, down here in the bottom we got all kinds of big stuff. This definitely would have been jamming up the bottom jet on that carburetor. So, otherwise this looks pretty good. There's some pitting from corrosion, but it's not going to cause a problem. This bowl I can actually probably just wipe out, scratch out some of this stuff that's in it, call it good. A little air pressure will go a long way on this one. In fact, I'm going to do that right now. Now another thing I like to do is I'll use this float bowl as a parts bin. So next up. So here's our float. We've got a little pin here that holds it in place. Usually you can just push him out. There's some corrosion built up on that even. The pick usually works good to push that pin out. Take that pin out, throw it in our parts bin. Now the float will come right out. The needle can also come out at this point. So what I'm looking for on floats usually, I'm going to take them out, clean them up, dry them off, inspect for any obvious damage. Cracks, shake it, feel if it's heavy, if there's any kind of fluid inside. Look at the profiles here, the bracket on it. This one's nice and straight, that's what we want. So next we've got our needle up in here. So you can just slide him out. Again, just wipe him off so you can get a good look at him. You want to look at this tip. See if there's any indentations built up in it. These are steel on our carburetors, so they hold up pretty well usually. The other big important thing is this plunger at the end of the needle. It's supposed to be spring-loaded. If yours is not spring-loaded, throw him and a cap full of carburetor cleaner. Let that sit for a few days until that is spring-loaded. This one's working great. So nothing to do there. Now we've got a couple of jets. Well, just one jet here. And I don't know what you call that, but it's the little housing where the needle goes. So we're going to pull that out. It's got a little gasket on it. Take care of him. Most of the parts, all the parts on these, as long as you don't damage them taking it apart, you can reuse them. So you don't need a kit for this. So just inspect this guy, make sure he's open down at this end and clear, clean. Next, we're going to pull out this jet tube. It's actually probably easiest to pull the jet out of it while it's locked into the carburetor so you have a way to hold it. Again, a good screwdriver here is key. You want to fit inside this jet. Can't see. There we go. Okay, so I just realized I had goofed up and the camera cut off just as I was taking this jet out of this tube. I just wanted to show you what was going on there. Obviously, this is not a big deal here. But so that's the jet that's coming out of it. And this is the tube you're going to take out of the body of the carburetor. Just wanted to show that, add this to the end of this clip.